It's because I've got the guts.
What are your priorities? If you're paying 20 grand for dinner, then it's not for the rubber chicken. It's to sit next to politicians and try and influence their decisions. And if you can't afford to pay to play, then you won't be there on the day. And you'll miss the nuance and the grey and the things they say to get their way. And although it's not corruption by any legal definition, it is only by their decisions the definitions are defined. And that's why there's no commission into federal corruption, and not a proper investigation into federal donations. There are rules and regulations, none of them are enforced, and there are no punishments, so nobody ever goes to court. Hello Senator, have some grange. By the way, there's a law that I'd like to change. How much democracy can I hack if I give you a six pack? We get the details of donations 12 to 18 months later, when the rich have already changed the laws to make their riches greater. And we're sitting on our asses while they pass the legislation that coincidentally helps the ones who are making the donations. People who have the power to decide our children's future are being shouting corporate cash for their own career booster. A revolving door of high-paying jobs within the government and private sector. Here's a contract, here's some cash, now let's all get rich together. There are three friggin' lobbyists for every politician who will take whatever they can get to pay for their elections, where they'll run 1,000 bullshit ads that divide the nation, funded by special interest groups and unions and lobbies and corporations. It's easy for casinos and the pokies to make profit when the gambling lobby's got Labor and Liberal in their friggin' pocket. Yes, the chips are stacked against you and it feels like a friggin' rort, but remember that democracy's not a spectator sport. So if the banks can stall decisions on the royal commissions and the fossil fuel industry can sponsor our whole democracy, then it's time we had a conversation about the state of our good nation. And we'll never get anywhere with it until we start to give a shit. If you actually do something, if you don't do nothing, probably, like I said, if you do something, yeah. So come on everybody, she'll be right, is what we tell ourselves every night. When we know that she'll be wrong, and deep down we've known it all along. Cause it's hard to do something, and it's easy to do nothing. But as we like and share and tweet and post, our democracy's getting away from us. So if you don't have a suitcase full of cash or 100 grand for rubber chicken and mash, then find some people who care as well and collectively give your politicians hell. Cause there's one thing they care more about than a millionaire's donation, and that's winning back their job again at the next election. She'll be